My connection with the world of nystagmus comes about through our eldest son, Sam, who was born in August 1983. When he was 3 months old, he was diagnosed with nystagmus. And so our journey began. No one to blame. When Sam was diagnosed with nystagmus, I think it's fair to say we were completely devastated. We never heard of the word, the condition. It was completely new territory to us. And at diagnosis, we were given hardly any information at all. I always remember the consultant saying, you've got a 50% chance of normal school for Sam, which turned out to be a completely meaningless statement, as people with nystagmus generally do go to mainstream school. But you drink all this in and you sort of worry about everything. But we had hardly any information to go on. All we knew was that our son couldn't see very well and wouldn't drive a car, almost certainly. The problem was there was nowhere to turn for supporting information, and then by chance we saw a newspaper article saying that research was being conducted into nystagmus at what was then called the London Refraction Hospital. It's now the Institute of Optometry. So we made an appointment to go and see Ron Mallett, who was leading the research, to find out more and for him to meet Sam. Obviously, we were very hopeful at the time that something would come of the research in terms of finding a treatment for nystagmus. He discussed the fact that it was a very lonely journey when you were diagnosed with a child with nystagmus, and we thought it would be a very good thing if there was a self-help group which brought people together so they could learn more about nystagmus and champion the cause, as it were. I can only say, speaking from personal experience, that the first time I met somebody with nystagmus, it was wonderful. I could ask them what they could see, what had happened to them in their lives, how they'd gone about getting jobs. It was a terrific relief to be able to meet and talk to people with nystagmus and to realise that despite having that problem, they'd gone on to live normal lives, they'd got work, they'd probably gone to university, they'd lived life, and that was enormously reassuring. Hearing your name, I really never felt quite the same since I lost what I had. The quality of our information has improved enormously, and we've got loads of documents that people can download free from the internet, and I think I'm very proud of that. That means that people who are newly diagnosed or have just found out about us can go onto the website and immediately answer their questions. That was the thing I couldn't do all those years ago when Sam was diagnosed. I suppose it never occurred to me at the beginning that 33 years later I'd still be sitting talking about it. At the beginning, the question was to get the organisation off the ground, and you're not perhaps thinking in terms of how long, you know, lies ahead. But I've been very thrilled by the way the charity has developed and by the calibre of people who've come onto the committee, by the calibre of the people who've worked for the charity. All this has helped the charity to develop to the point where when you go on that website, you get a huge amount of information to download. And of course, through the open days and through the website and through Twitter and Facebook, you can contact people and talk to them about the whole issue of nystagmus and what it means to have nystagmus.